5, 8, and 9. In this day of fast food, cell phones, computers, instant messenger, and having things our way. We are used to immediate gratification. We want what we want, when we want it, and how we want it. And nothing else matters. Many are familiar with the song I Did It My Way, written by Paul Anka and sung by Frank Sinatra in the late 1960s. I Did It My Way is a great song whose lyrics were beautifully sung by Frank Sinatra. As Christians, we must contrast that song with the life of Jesus. When you read Matthew's account of Jesus' baptism, which marks the beginning of his ministry, we see that Jesus rejected the option of doing it my way. He chose to live life God's way. The song that Frank Sinatra made famous has become such a classic that it often used at funerals. This will tell us that many have no clue as to what God wants of us. By using this song, they are saying that the song expresses an accurate description of their lives. That personal philosophy on which this song is based is the exact opposite to the Christian who is truly following Jesus. This is not what we should want to epitomize our lives. We should want to be known as Christians doing things that way. Many people are searching about the meaning of things, and I do believe that most people really want to live a meaningful life. But sad to say, many just plod along a life that is empty and dissatisfied. Perhaps this is the reason that many people turn to suicide. God is ready to give a happy, satisfying life, but unfortunately, many people have rejected his salvation and would prefer to do things their way. Many people act as though that they know more about life than God. When we try to manage our lives by ourselves, we find ourselves with perplexing problems for which we have no solutions. We face many problems that we did not foresee. We must be remembering the promise of God in Isaiah 45, verse 2, I will go before you and make the rough places smooth. I will shatter the tools of bronze and cut through the iron bars. An incident from the popular Peanuts cartoon series makes this point. Lucy speaking to her little brother, Linus. Lucy asks, what is the matter with you? Linus answers, I have a sliver in my finger. Lucy responds, that means you are being punished for something. What have you done wrong lately? Linus answers, I haven't done anything wrong. Lucy says, you have a sliver, haven't you? That's a misfortune, isn't it? You are being punished with misfortune because you have been bad. Many people are like Lucy. They picture God is always angry and ready to give revenge. To them, every uncomfortable experience in life is brought about by God, who is punishing them for some past mistake. Paul states that God blesses us not only on the basis of deeds which we have done, but according to his mercy. Titus 3:5. God has created us to walk in perfect harmony with him and to enjoy his fellowship and his blessings. True meaning in life can be discovered only as we go God's way. In fact, as we draw nearer to God, the questions that once bothered us, such as why or why me, become less important. Instead, our trust in God grows and our confidence in him is constantly being reinforced. Questions are replaced with exclamation marks. G.I. Papa writes, those who know God have great contentment. And he adds, there is no peace like the peace of those whose minds are possessed with full assurance that they have known God and God has known them, and that this relationship guarantees God's favor to them in life through death and on forever. It is no wonder that too many people grasp at straws trying to find meaning and contentment. They have missed the whole point of life. What are we made for? We are made to know God. What should be our purpose in life? Our purpose should be to know God. Jesus taught this with unmistakable clarity. This is eternal life, which they may know the only true God and Jesus Christ whom thou hast sent. John 17:3. The initial experience of knowing Christ brings salvation. The Apostle Paul speaks of his desire to continue to know him and to know him more and more as a primary goal in life for him as a believer, that I will know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being conformed to his death. Philippians 3:10. To know God in this way will cost something, since God has called us to a life of fellowship with His Son. 1 Corinthians 1:9. We can be sure that it will bring us into such an experience. This purposeful working of God in our lives is gentle and persuasive. It is a loving Father working to keep His children close to Himself. And if we love Him in return, we will then be happy to surrender ourselves to His loving care. We will trust Him even when it hurts, and even when we have no immediate answer to explain what we are experiencing. We have problems with this process when we resist God and determine to go our own way. For many, this resistance becomes a contest of wills. Will it be my way or God's way, my will or His? Which way we go becomes a matter of choice. If we choose to do it our own way, then we must be prepared for the discontent and frustration and the unanswered questions in a life without meaning. On the other hand, if we choose to surrender the reins of our life to God, we discover real meaning in life, along with the contentment that comes with that discovery. We will receive it only after we have surrendered our wills to God at all costs. So will it be your way or His? Will it be your will or His? God has a perfect plan for us. It is a plan that brings great glory to Him. It is also a plan that brings meaning and contentment to our lives. If we choose to follow this way of surrender, it will be because we have come to trust His great love to give Him our best. I began this Bible reflection with Paul's Anka's great classic, I Did It My Way, and I want to close it with I Did It God's Way, with different lyrics by Sam Minahim, but with the same tune.
This is Samuel Paul Amonjo.
to believe I feel bad.